So now we're going on to hear from Snap, obviously one of the most innovative and important tech platforms in our industry. It's David Norris. And David, who is incredible, I've got his exact job title, he's European Head of Creative Strategy. He's fantastic. He's going to talk about, the future of AR. We all know AR has been totally sort of reborn through the last 18 months. But David Norris, the incredible David Norris, the stage is yours.
Morning, guys. Well, afternoon now, isn't it? But this is lovely. Like, what a nice thing to be able to do, actually seeing people and talking to real people. But what Justin didn't tell me was that I was A, following Cadbury's, and that also they'd give you all free chocolate. So I hadn't kind of planned for that. But what I have got for you guys is actually a photo of my sofa, which is hopefully you're like super happy with that. But the reason for that is, I guess, like most of you guys, I've spent a lot of the time recently on my sofa. And I've spent a lot of time on my sofa. I've completed Netflix, and I've actually done a lot of my work on my sofa. And I take my work very, very seriously. Particularly bald me. I'm very, very serious about bald me. It's something that is really important to me, so I have to be careful what's happening with my hair. But the point here isn't just like, it's just, hey, AR is a bit of fun. This isn't just me on my sofa playing with AR. Actually, there's 200 million people every single day engaging with AR. There's 5 billion snaps created every single day, like ridiculous volume, like the behavior, the way you talk about AR, sometimes it can be like this like niche gimmicky thing over here. It's like, no, it's a genuine behavior that is there every single day. And the easiest way to think about AR in the context of advertising is just one of attention. Like, that's what AR gives you. Like, genuine connection, genuine attention with someone who's engaging with it on the device that is probably the most important device in their life. But when you think about attention, what attention really is marketing, right? Like, that's, if you can get attention, that gives you the opportunity to communicate your message. Now, the title of this section around kind of retail and kind of re-engaging from a retail point of view, like when you think about attention in the context of the world that we've all been living through, attention's been really hard to get, right? Like, stuff's been closed, like people have been staying at home. How do you actually get the attention? And it's seen a real shift and step towards augmented reality, not just from the kind of the makeup world, which I think most people in the room will be very familiar with, that easy leap of like, oh, I want to try some lipstick on whatever. But actually, when you think about AR and how it shifted, more and more brands are recognizing the role it can play to bring them to life, like to create an experience, to get that attention from a consumer. And it's got to the point where, from our side, like we look at it and we absolutely see this as being like the fastest trend in retail. When you look at some research from Spotify, they came out with this, that 94% of interactions with products that have AR will be more likely to get converted. Like, it's just a tangible interaction, but it's one that's also so valuable because you're getting that attention. And like, then you come again into the world that we most, I assume, in this room connect to in terms of advertising, marketing, and brands. It's like, yeah, cool, I get the behaviors there, I get making yourself bald. But actually, what we see now is actually from some new research that over half of consumers are actually like actively looking for branded AR experiences to help them make those decisions, to help them make those choices. But then that kind of brings me back to my sofa. And it's like, okay, cool. So there's you play with your hair, you play with the different lenses. But from the safety of your sofa, like what we've seen is like brands have the ability to actually step inside a store, like create a retail environment that you can actually step and experience and walk around and explore from the safety of that sofa. Or maybe actually it's a product piece and I want to find out a bit more about this product. I'm really into this shoe. I think it looked kind of cool, but I wonder what it's made of. Like, rather than kind of having to scroll through endless things, actually I can just have this experience where I can control what I'm engaging with, what I'm looking at, how I'm kind of looking at it and finding out the different layers and detail that sit within that experience that you can create. Now, the bit that's probably exploding fastest is one around kind of try on. And like the shifts in the technology that sits within the camera, being able to recognize someone's face and put things on a face, that's pretty easy, right? We've been doing that for years. But the evolutions that we've seen now in terms of kind of actually trying on a product, particularly from a kind of shoe point of view, and like the ability to look down at your feet, whatever shoes you've got on or nothing on, and actually see in situ a pair of shoes you want to look at. But maybe you want to just tap through and change the color, check the different colorway out. That's super easy. And then you want to walk around, it's going to track you, it's going to work you, it's going to follow you going through. And like what's really, really exciting is kind of this is something that you kind of expect, I don't know, you'd expect Gucci to maybe do this, right? Gucci love being at the front of anything new. They've got 400 pound sneakers. Yeah, they're going to do this. But what's really exciting is when you think of brands like Adidas or Vans, like brands that are actually now recognizing try on should just be a fundamental part of their communications mix, of their plan. Like the camera is now part of their comms plan. Like having this, we've got a shoe, we can scan the shoe, we can create it very, very, it's a very simple lift technical wise to create, but just having it there, but all having that kind of connection through to site, to buy, to try. And like we're not just kind of stopping when you think about shoe trying, like that's amazing, I love my shoe sneaks, so it's like it's a great space to be in. But actually we're pushing more and more in terms of how else can we evolve the technology? How else can we develop that behavior to enable those moments to get capture attention? So this is something called true size in terms of actually the ability to recognize the different dimensions of someone's face to actually serve a different experience to match and fit for their size. Or the Prada example, like the ability to actually, you've set your phone over there, I'm gonna step back, I wanna have a look at what this bag's gonna look like. But then just being able to use gesture just to change the color options, just to see what's there. And then, so we're just scratching the surface in terms of these kind of evolutions in how you can drive that attention and how you can drive that engagement. All the way through to more recently, a piece of work that we've just launched with Farfetch using voice.
With this new lens, seeing the latest styles is as easy as saying what you're looking for.
Can you show me a windbreaker jacket?
And if you're not quite sure and want to see other styles, just say it.
Maybe something with a pattern.
Using natural language voice commands.
That's awesome. Take a snap.
When you.
It's like the ability to stand there and use your voice to call out, I want to try this off-white jacket. And then, hey, actually, you know what? I want to change the style. Like when you think about the experience of walking around a store and finding different things, but actually enabling that when you're at home, just like an incredible opportunity. And then on top of that is like all of these connections, as you saw on the try-on piece a minute ago, is like you have these moments of attention. You have these moments of connection where someone's there. They're trying the shoe on. They're trying the jacket on. They're having that rich brand experience with you. And then all of them, every single one, can drive through to site, can drive through to purchase. So the ability of like, oh, is that going to play? The ability in this case with the Mac example, like there's so much going on in here. Right, in terms of like the different products to trial to find, like the application of the foundation, the different lipstick that you want to apply, the different shades, all the different names of the different shades. Like, it's just a full holistic shopping experience. And can anyone just imagine, like, not that I did it that often, but going into the makeup shop counter and the lipstick counter, and then just wiping the top of it with a cloth and passing it to you to try on. Like that's never going to happen again. And kind of like the depth and simplicity of the connection, but also from a audience point of view, buying stuff through mobile is so easy. It's so natural. It's so intuitive for them. So there's no hesitation to actually, yeah, I want to pick that up. Particularly, obviously, off the back of the surge of behavior change that we've kind of all been through over this last season. But I know you've probably all got a question burning in your head, like, but really, like, why did I have those cushions on the sofa? It's a mad pattern or whatever. My wife chose them. But the bit to tool out and say, like, does this actually work? Like, it's great having, like, yeah, that's super cool. I can try on trainers on my feet. That's insane. But, like, if you're a brand and advertiser, do you really want to invest in creating those experiences? Do you want to invest in getting people to see them? But, like, the case studies that we're seeing more and more flow through in terms of the brands that are adopting these, not just doing the one-off hits, but committing to the role that the camera can play in their communications mix. Like you take Gucci. Gucci saw an incredible 2.5 times pretty much like higher purchasing. Like it genuinely shifted the needle in terms of, I want to buy those shoes. Obviously they're still £400, so there's another step to take on top of that. But like that's great, so it's driving purchasing, but what about like actual buying stuff? Like, if you're doing AR, will people actually buy it? So another example is a collaboration that Tommy Hilfiger did with Looney Tunes, brought out this super limited edition range of the collaboration. And what we saw just in 1 week was over 1,600 purchases direct through the lens experience, all tracked and accounted for in terms of actually shifting the product. Like, you've created an immersive, in this case, it was a portal lens experience where you could step inside and explore the collection, but it also gave you, for a limited period of time at the start of that week, this was the exclusive window to access. That was the only place you could get the product. Like, if you went through the AR experience, then that's where you could try it, that's where you could experience it, that's where you could actually go through and purchase it. So, like, an incredible thing. We're seeing more and more success from more brands. And again, the metric that I always come back to is like, does it actually shift the behavior of the brand and the media agency and the creative agency to be thinking about the role that AR, the role that the camera can play for them, not just today, but every day? Like, that real shift in kind of the way that you're seeing it. But we've kind of talked, this is kind of what's here right now. This is what exists. Now, the bit that I guess people often ask is like, great, but what's next? Right, where is this going? What else can we do? What else is possible? What's new? What's different? And so I wanted to talk, I've realized this is a very sneaker-themed presentation, but as everyone's out today, which is great to be out and about, if anyone wants something else to do today, given there's no football on, is if you head over to the Design Museum, incredible space, incredible building, highly recommend it, wonderful space. There's an exhibition at the moment called Sneakers Unboxed, which is an incredible exhibition about the history of kind of sneaker design and kind of the influence it's had on culture and society and everything. So we partnered with the Design Museum to kind of talk about, hey, what could we do in and around this exhibition? Like, what could we create that would be interesting or different or unique? And obviously, like, the first point you get to is like, hey, yeah, sneaker trial. Wouldn't it be amazing if you could do a sneaker trial for all the best sneakers that have ever existed? And we thought about doing that. And then we thought, actually, maybe there's a different angle. And about 8 to 9 months ago, we opened up what we call Snap ML, so machine learning. Just, it's a slightly more accessible way of talking about machine learning. And we basically fed in to the computer those 100 sneakers. Like, these are the best sneakers that are in the collection. This is what makes up that exhibition. And we thought we'd ask the computer a question, like, could you create the next one? Could you create Sneaker Zero, the one that actually is based on all the icons of sneakers that have existed, and create that as an experience? And it was pretty fun to work on. Yeah, super fun experience to work on, to create. And if you go down to the Design Museum, you can check it out, you can unlock it and play with it. But just, I guess, the overriding thing to talk about and take away from these few minutes is like the role that the camera can play in your comms plan. Like, the behavior exists, right? This isn't something that's there for the future. It's 200 million people every day on Snap engaging with AR. What role can it play for you in retail, but also what role could it play in the broader mix of your communications, of how you're trying to get that crucial thing, which is attention? So I reckon for about the first time in my life, I've done one of these things where I've got to the end before this thing starts like going red and shouting at you of like, stop talking. So yeah, that was all I wanted to share. So thank you very much.
David, thank you so much. Fantastic presentation. But now we've got some questions.
Great.
Can I ask one first from me? What does AR mean for the rebirth of the high street? What role is it going to play? Because obviously the high street has been battered. We're coming out of this pandemic. Where's AR's place?
Yeah. So I think, I mean, AR creates such an opportunity, I think, for brands to build their spectrum of connection points, I guess, with people, but in particular with the high street. like just add a layer of experience. So it can enhance, like it can enhance that experience of sitting on the sofa, but equally if you're in store, it can unlock a whole other world of experience or value or product or discount or loyalty or whatever spectrum you want to apply. It can create another pathway of engagement. And it's kind of, I think if you're looking at getting people back into store, it's how do you make that more memorable and more motivational to keep going back. And I think if you can add a layer of experience that's not a you know, a huge set design that you're putting in place, but actually something that's scalable across any retail store anywhere, I think that's probably what I'd focus on.
Great. One here from Bobby who asks, she or he, I'm not sure, asks, what is the role of measurement in AR and how is it developing?
Role of measurement is crucial, right? I'm not sure where Bobby is. Hi, Bobby, whoever you are. Role of measurement is crucial because it's that kind of validation of, like, we can talk about scale, we can talk about reach, but it's kind of when you actually see brand metrics shifting, but not just the awareness metrics, but the consideration metrics, the conversion metrics, like the fact that the camera can shift all of those, like measurement is crucial. The bit that is obviously an open question, I guess, as an industry, is kind of as AR grows more and more as a channel, kind of having a unified view of what that metric could look like is a really interesting thing that I know our measurement team are looking at. Alongside people like the IAB and things, but like for me, it's crucial in that validation of the role AR can play throughout the funnel.
Excellent question here from Ed. How far do you think we are from photorealistic AR, and do you think this would increase purchase?
So two things there, Ed. Hi, Ed, wherever you are. Two things there. One is like, you should come and have a play with some of these because the experience is super strong. And basically, the process at the moment is for, say, AR try-on, is that you take the actual shoe and you photo scan it in 3D and then you translate that to deliver in AR. Now, the bit in terms of the question, currently, every single lens experience that I've just shown you exists within 4 megabytes of file size. And it does that for the main reason to be a good experience, right? We've all been there where you get the wheel of death on whatever it is of something loading and it's just a rubbish experience. So the reason for 4 megs is to enable that kind of instant experience and engagement. Now, obviously, we're all getting closer and closer to kind of 5G rollout and penetration. And then in theory, that 4 megabytes of file size can translate to 50, 60 megabytes of file size to have the same instant experience. So just imagine, not just from a try-on product point of view, but just imagine what else you could possibly create in the future.
Okay, last one here from Bryn, who asks, how accessible is this sort of thing for brands? I work at a very small brand but would love to experiment.
Great question. So it's never been more accessible, both from a creative point of view and a media point of view. So in terms of creation, we have... come and find me afterwards and I can give you the links. But we have something called Lens Web Builder, which is integrated within our Ads Manager platform that lets you instantly create from pre-populated thousands, but pre-populated of AR elements that you can customize and create and push straight to your ad account. So literally anyone can do that. We also have Lens Studio, which is a free to use piece of software, which is what we use internally, but we've opened it out to anyone to be able to use, that has customizable, easy to follow templates within them. So, you know, graphic designers, creative agencies, where it's so easy to step into and create, originate incredible experiences. So that's kind of the next level up. And then there's a growing stream of production partners that we work with who are specialists in this area. So there's more and more scope and potential for creation. But yeah, for us, it's never been more accessible from a media point of view to then pay and promote and access those to the people you want to target, but also from a creative point of view to democratize it and make it easier to access. But yeah, come and find me afterwards if you want to find any of those links.
Fantastic. David, thank you so much. David Norris from Snap.